We had Altuve on the show. Gosh, I love that guy. Oh, the Houston Astros, he was just unbelievable. And you guys have gotten kind of close. I didn't realize this.
No, we've hung out for a few years now. I mean, I take batting practice with the Astros.
Do you really?
Almost every year, yeah. But he's better than me at that, too.
Yeah.
But, no, he's a great guy. He's so much fun. He's fun-loving. I mean, and he's incredible. He's such an incredible athlete. He's also, like, up to the... He's like this.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's very interesting, because you see, you're sitting on a stool and he's standing completely.
But he's the man. He's the man.
I mean, he's fantastic. I couldn't get enough of him on TV. I was watching him every time I saw him. I'm like, he just seems like a cool guy.
He dances. He's the man.
He's just great, and he's obviously just hitting homers and doesn't even care.
It was the coolest thing. So I was sitting at home watching the World Series, obviously, with everybody, and I was out on my back porch, and he'd hit a home run, and you could literally hear the cheers from all over the whole neighborhood. I thought that was...
Isn't that the greatest?
One of the coolest things in the whole world, and I think that's why it's so cool to share the cover with this guy, because, I mean... To be able to bring a city together through sports and to be able to, through of all the seasons you can win a World Series, of all the seasons you could ever win your first World Series, to do it at a time like this. And I saw this one photo where they didn't have any drywall in their house. They didn't have any furniture. They were sitting on 5-gallon buckets and they were watching a TV that they had rigged up and they were watching us win the World Series and cheering. And I think that was such a powerful message that sports are so much bigger than just hitting a ball out of the park. You're literally lifting people's spirits and making them forget about what they're going through for that minute. Yeah. And I think Jose and the guys deserve so much credit for that.
Absolutely. And he sent you something, right, after they won the World Series?
He did.
What did he send you?
He sent me a bottle of whiskey, which is always accepted. So.
Hey, Ben's
like a Christmas
Jose,
gift.
Christmas, yeah, exactly. Whenever.
But it came with a great letter. I mean, it came with a really special letter that I thought was a real class move by Jose, and it just speaks to the type of person he is.
We brought the letter here, and I was just wondering if you would mind just maybe reading it to
everyone. Yeah, of course. This
is for real.
It speaks the type of person he is. He's a great guy. So he said, JJ, from one H-Town brother to another, thanks for all you've done this year for the city that you call home. Your support for all things Houston, from hurricane relief to being our number one fan, has been nothing short of incredible. So I hope you'll accept this fine whiskey gift I gave to all my teammates following our championship run, because to me, you're absolutely part of the squad. Cheers, Jose. So, I mean, that's a good guy. That's a good guy.
Isn't that great?
Yeah.
That's just a great dude right there. I should say the awards will be aired Friday night on NBC Sports Network. JJ, we're so psyched that you're here. We're so thankful and happy that you exist.
Thank you, buddy.
JJ Watt, everybody. The Sports Illustrated Sports Person of the Year issued his newsstands on Wednesday. Tune in Friday night at 8 p.m. on the NBC Sports Network to watch the Sports Person of the Year award show.
On and on and on. And it's on and on and on.